Oh, thank you for the follow, Kat. I didn't even know you haven't even followed yet. Yeah, you finally catch it. I just came from a cookout. I'm putting out notifications now. But I'm checking out Remnant 2. I just got the game, just updated my drivers, and I'm putting out my stuff. So let me go ahead and just continue putting out promos. Just give me a moment. I got a lot of channels I can promote myself in. Have you played this game before, Theo? Neither have I, but this game has been on my radar for the illest minute. I'm gonna still promote myself on your server, just in case anyone else wants to join. That should be good. No, we'll go here too, just in case for Audra. Almost done, just got three more places to share. Brain does not brain. What? But yeah, I just came from a cookout not too long ago. I had an earlier stream. Oh, you wanted to follow on stream. I gotcha. Gotcha. Well, thank you nonetheless. Took me a little bit long to get ready because I had to get rid of... Oh my god, my controller is being a douche. Oh hey, Cry's live. There you open him. My controller is trying to murder me. Controller. Oh, hey, Joey. Thank you for the lurk. Come on, controller. I know you're a cheap knockoff PS4 controller, but come on. Do I need to bust out the other controller? Okay, wait. My cord not working. Oh god, is it really a stream without any scuff? Alright, I'm gonna try and see if I can Bluetooth it. Nope, it's not wanting to Bluetooth. Why scuff already? What did I do to deserve this? Give me a second. Let me bust up my other controller. See if this one works better. Yeah, exactly. Pain moment. I got another controller, though, that I can try and use. It's brand new. Audio is being sent to the controller, isn't it? Oh.
I don't like the looks of this.
Ugh! I like that voice line. I don't know what all this is, but I don't want to find out. There, let's get that poopy control out of the way.
Not bad.
No.
I could use that.
Okay, I like that one. Oh my god. It is. Okay, it's not cursed anymore, but I guess this is gonna. Oh, no. It got cursed. I guess that one? Oh wow, there's really not a lot of customization available. I guess we'll do top knot. White. Should we give ourselves facial hair? Cat, should I give myself facial hair? What do you think? Facial hair or no facial hair? I think I'll do no for now. What does hardcore mean? Oh, no, 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 no. I like number 4. That's pretty hard. Yeah, 4 goes hard. What markings do we have? Yeah, that's really nothing. That's really nothing. That's really nothing. That's almost nothing. Nothing. I think we're gonna go with that. I don't know how to play. So we're gonna go with Survivor. So this is a game where each player's world is kind of like randomized. Oh god, it's using PS5. It's using Xbox controls, so I'm gonna have to learn that. Gunfire Games. Oh, I need to charge my phone. Remnant 2. She a strong, independent woman, man. Don't question her. She got this. She got this. You okay? We dead already, and the game hasn't even started yet.
Broken or bleeding. It'll calm down. It always does. Let's go. Kit said the ward was this way.
Okay.
You ever hear about the North Pole?
That old fairy tale?
Yeah. Like this war. Old white guy founds it. Food and fresh water, everyone gets along. That sounds like a fairy tale to me. It's probably just a couple of old timers holed up underground.
Can't do anything yet.
They got a few supplies for trade. Otherwise, we won't last much longer. You think people actually live like this?
not sure.
I don't know what's in that Fulton's original blend, but I never seen nobody that happy before. Not in real life.
Okay. I'm learning. I didn't press attack, but okay. Okay, so that's dodge. Square is interact. Ooh, item. What do I do?
Hey, look at this. What happened to these poor bastards? Can't let it go to waste. Use it on that bum ankle of yours. Won't help me none. Hey, come on. Let's get some distance between us. Hey, over here.
Okay, that's how I shoot. I'm not attacking. Hey, Bun Bun, how you doing? I have no idea what I'm doing. But I'm doing things. My summon ain't beetle eating right now, so shut up.
Oh, this is bad. This is bad with a side of rock.
A side of what?
Nothing. Something my mom used to say. Deadwood! Shoot the damn thing!
I'm good. I just came from a cookout. Why does it keep on doing attacks? I'm not hitting the attack button, but it's attacking. So weird. Oh, this seems like a boss. All right, there's gotta be something down here. I didn't press attack. She died.
Maybe best we head back. We retrace our steps. We can find another way out.
Whoa. Damn. That's weird. It looks perfectly fine to me.
Not today, asshole.
Is everything fine for you? Theo, it's showing fine on my end. I'm watching from my Twitch. Was this scripted, Law? What?
It's okay. You're safe. Whoa, hold up. We're friends. We're here to help.
Can't hold this forever, Bo!
Is everything fine on your end, Theo?
Thanks. Who are you?
Questions later. We gotta get moving. One. Two. Three.
The fuck?
That's all I got. You're on your own now.
Hey, we still got each other.
Right. Follow us, you two. That won't be the last of them.
Okay, can I loot real quick? Because there's some loot on the ground. I can. Oh, I can't. The loot is gone.
not far from here. The way down collapsed behind us. We're gonna have to find another way out.
I'm not doing the attack. Enjoy your lunch, man. All right, reload. Sorry guys, switching out the cord, hoping that that fixed it. All right, we beat him.
Okay.
Not bad food, Trevor.
Yeah. That's not good.
Yeah. Safer. So, it's really real. Food, and water, and... folks living with some old white guy. More or less.
Whoa, whoa, let me get you some water.
I'm fine, I...
Cass, ooh, that looks like root rot. I've never seen a case this bad.
I'm fine. I don't know why everyone...
We need to get her to the room, quick.
I don't even know what we just fought. What was that called? Root something? I don't even know what the frick that was called. Was it like Root Walker or something?
Oh yeah.
This is Riggler.
Call me Riggs.
Riggs, my guy.
Check in with Ford, and then I'll get some rest, okay? I've been through a lot worse, you know.
So, Traveler, your friend will be fine. I'm Bo Ward, and this is Ward 13. You must have come a long way. I mean, the route's dwindling and all, but the road's still a dangerous place. What were you two doing out there? Yeah, well, you'll be safe here for as long as you need, Traveler. I didn't know anybody knew what we were doing out here. Feels kind of nice, actually. Hey, ask around if you need something. Oh, start with Ford. I'm sure he'd like to meet you.
Root ganglia. Root mantis. That's what that thing is called. Don't switch.
Hope you stick around, stranger. I've got a good feeling about you.
Can't shoot him.
You think
the newcomer, ain't you? Nora Camarillo. I keep folks alive around here. You know, you're lucky they found you when they did. Your friend was pretty bad.
Pretty much. Any part of your flesh prison breaks down, you come to me.
Flesh prison.
Knock yourself out.
Let's read the book. I spent so much time flipping through the old medical journals that Grandpa and I scrounged up. I recognized, may well start one of my own. Maybe in the future someone will dig into this like I have an idea what his life was like in War 13. It's a nice thought, anyhow. Jabe came by for a visit while Lily was harvesting in the garden. He'd cut his thumb tilling the earth, but didn't complain none. He and Lily are something else. I don't know where we'd be without that little garden of theirs. It not only brings folks together, but it also has us all eating healthy and gives lots of good ingredients from our herbal supplements. Best part is that they grow more than carrots and tomatoes in that garden. Sprouted up a sweet little love story as well. Everyone thought they were loony, hoarding up seeds and dreaming of a garden. But just look at what they accomplished. Two folks working together to achieve a shared goal for the good of everyone and finding love along the way. Fills my heart with joy just thinking about it. The founder, Ford, is a tough nut to crack, I tell you. I can tell he's still hurt really bad about losing Ellen. It ain't right, burying your own grandkid. I tried to get him to open up, offered something to help him sleep or take him off the edge of the pain, but he just brushes it off. I can see a world of hurt in those eyes, but he prefers keeping to himself, and I suppose that's his right. Everyone handles heartaches in their own way. Those rowdy kids scraped themselves up good today, running all over our creation pretending to be mud dogs. One was howling about a broken arm, but it turned out it was just a nasty bruise. Thank goodness. It'll heal up in no time. Gotta love their exuberance. But I sure wish they were pretending to be doctors instead of no good bandits. Maybe I should have a chat with Mudtooth about these stories of his. Dwayne came with an upset stomach again. Poor thing. I told him if it looks nasty, don't eat it. We got plenty to fill our bellies now. No need to eat some weird bug or rancid piece of some meat. He thinks it's a skill of sorts, seeing anything. But I told him his taste and smell are his body's ways of protecting him. Gave him the usual to settle his stomach, but it won't last be long until he's back for more. Poor Wally. I feel so bad for that one. Some folks think he's a bit touched in the head, but it's not like that. He's just got bad dreams. Always has, as long as I've known him. I bring him some sleepy time tea to try and help him. Every now and then, he humors me, but I have a feeling that tea is just watering down the garden and it never makes it down his throat. Doubt it'd help anyway, but I gotta try. It's my job to help folks here. Still more. What am I gonna do with that old Mudtooth? He was still as a stone in his chair earlier, and I was sure he was a goner. Then he scared me half to death with the loudest snore I ever heard. I'm thankful he was okay. Still, when he's not dozing off, he's ladling up that stew of his. I know he's trying to help, but I don't think folks know what they're getting into with it. Folks who are eating too much of it come knocking, feeling like their hearts are beating too fast and they can't sit still. All I can do is try and give them some nice tea and try to keep them distracted and calm until the effects wear off. That ain't normal stew, I swear. It took Riggs over my knee and whooped him. That man was suffering something like pneumonia and kept right on working like nothing was wrong. It took him just about passing out at his forge before McCab to let me know what was what. The two of us practically had to drag him here. Imagine what would have happened to morale if we lost Riggs. Found a small piece of scrap on my table the next day. He'd never admit it, but I think that was his way of thanking me. He's so dang nice. Whispers come through for some throat lozenges today. I always make sure that I have some just around for him. He was stabbed in the throat a good while back, and now he can't talk. Has to scribble away on that little chalkboard of his. I looked through all my scrounge to trying to find somewhere to help him, and I've tried this or that, but there's nothing for it. Can't heal everyone, as Grandpa says. Flesh prisons will let you down eventually, so you gotta make sure your soul's in good shape. Since that's all you get to keep in the end. The longer I'm a doctor, the more that rings true. Reggie slowed down a bit, fair bit in the recent years. I know he's getting on in age, but it's tough to see. Couldn't ask for a gentler soul. He loves chatting, but I think he keeps telling the same stories over and over again. Like, he doesn't know. He's already sent them to you. I read about this. I'm not sure it's something I can fix, unfortunately. It's not. And it's likely to get worse over time. So I just smile like I've never heard the story before. Don't think I could bring myself to tell him that I've heard some of them hundreds of times already. Anyone callous enough to make Reggie sad doesn't belong in War 13. Oh my god, how many pages are there? Just like Founder, Ford, and Bo, our little clam ain't aging like normal. There's something to it, but I can't put my finger on it. None of my books can explain something like that. Bo seems to think he takes good care of himself, but I'm not sure that's all that tracks. That aside, I can tell Clem is sad. Poor girl carries the weight of the world on her shoulders, and much like Ford, won't let anyone in. Maybe a diary would help. Somewhere to vent the things she doesn't want to share. Had a nice little chat with McCab today. Her joints were aching a bit, so I gave her some salve. She works hard, she comes off tough, but really she's a sweetheart. She'd kill me if I told anyone, so I'll keep it to myself. He's flat enough, but I don't know what to think about Dwell. He's from Heck, some places I don't ever think of. He's always talking about some Doan Ravager, gives me the willy. Still, he's one of us, so I hope if he ever needs me, I can help him some way. I don't know a thing about pan physiology, so I'm just crossing my fingers that it doesn't come up. Heard a rumor that one of our Tones folks keeps getting jittery and keeps talking about leaving. Hopefully it's just talk. They've got to know that they wouldn't last long out there on their own. Our gal Clam can't save everyone who wanders too far outside our walls. I figure I'll try and find who it is and whip up some anti-anxiety herbs to help calm them down. That'll be a mite easier than trying to patch them up if they do try and leave. Okay, we just read the entire book. Gotcha. Got no speech. Need protection out there? I sell armor. Stabbed in the neck, long time ago. Long time now. Left bank again. Lady Commander took me in. I'm actually curious. Got old, no old bandits. People are nice. Food is good. Good life. Okay. Ooh. That's kind of sexy. And you can too.
So you come in with Bo and Clementine there. Or you can be sure they'll do everything they can for your friend. Ain't the first to come through here needing help. I have been known to tell a story or two. The old Mud Tooth does give me a run for my money. Or did you mean that I collect the stories? Because I do that too. And I'd love to hear your tale, Traveler. Sounds like the start of a damn good story. What brought you out here? Damn. It's a common enough tale. But I hope you know I'm genuinely sorry for your loss. Everyone here can identify. But I know that don't necessarily make it easier. All we can do is shelter the joy wherever we find it, every day. How about your friend? How'd you meet her? So you were over the debt. Maybe you paid it off by moving here. Hey, what do I know? I tell you what, though. Ain't no good to tear people's lives. We look out for each other because we're human, yeah? It's the only way that makes sense to me. The only thing that makes humanity worth being around. Speaking of your friend, I heard you came in with a nasty case of root rot. What happened to you two out there? another gun. Those sneaky bastards just don't know when to quit. And I'm real sorry to hear that, Traveler. It must have been one hell of an experience. I'm glad you made it. Well, don't you worry. We've dealt with nastier things here, believe me. I reckon you'll come through just fine. What about you? What do you hope to find out here? Man, there's no shortage of lingering deadwood, let me tell you. We ain't overrun. We ain't rid of them yet either. So now I've got a measure of you. Is there anything I can do for you? Only the best for my friend.
What is this? Ammo box? That's pretty good. Confidence booster. Dang. That's pretty good.
Keep your wits about you.
Well, hey, get away from my stoop. Oh, nonsense. I'm sure you had a reason. Mi casa et tu, Brute.
Dude is funny.
Oh, careful now. My answers are known to lead to more questions. Quite a bit, stranger. The name's Mudtooth. And ain't nobody been around longer or seen more than I have. Except maybe old Ford, of course. But that old mudder cheats. Anyway, he hardly tells any of his stories. Only three reasons why folks come to see me, and that town called. Back in my day, a place like this wouldn't be considered much more than a camp or a bivouac, you might call it.
Oh, what?
This ain't no town. Not yet. But it is a fine place to set up camp. I lived by myself for years, see? Had myself a hockopotopter. That thing could fly to the moon and back. It could. Anywho, I was living by myself when my boy Bravis showed up saying we should move on. Told me it wasn't safe for me to be living like I was living no more. He told me about this place. That's some nice. Get some dead used to being around folks.
Eat too, Merte. So give me a second, I'm fixing my chair rug.
Well, Rabbit, he's my son. For his idea to come join this little family. Not a bad idea it was. He's over yonder, at the shooting range. That so? Huh. That one too, eh? Well, that's it, ain't it? My stories and my stories. Listen, you sure I said there were three reasons? Huh. Only two reasons folks come to see old Mudtooth, and you know both of them. I'm pretty sure your memory's slipping. You bet your apple I can. Objective retellings of legitimate currencies, what you wouldn't believe. Now, where to start? This city ain't without its own tale. Why, there's a tower, see? What only appears once in a given August moon. Kinda looks like a big yellow-orange pumpkin. And within that tower is a man. Except he's not a man. He's a wizard, see? He calls himself the Keeper, and he controls everything. I've seen him myself. Even talked to him once. Man, smart as hell. So smart, even I can't keep up with him.
You're pretty dumb, man.
He says he watches over all of us. But if that's the case, then he ain't been doing such a good job. Look around. I reckon he means well. And that tower is like a spaceship he uses to teleportate to other planets. You go walk the city in the harvest pumpkin moon. You'll see what I mean. You'll like this one. Did I tell you I once sailed across that ocean to that old rusted tower? It was after that wanderer came through here and cleared out the storm. Old Mudtooth's crazy, you know, but I ain't stupid. I tell you,
stupid.
Down there that you ain't never seen in your life. Down there in that rusted place was just machinery and root twist every which way, like the root themselves had built it. But they didn't. No, that old place was called Ward 10 and 7. You can see it plastered all over, and it was built by humans. Ward himself used to serve, if you can believe that. Oh, he'll deny it, I'm sure. But all them electronicals they got down there are the same damn things you'll find in old Ward 10 and 3. That place, I know he found it. His founder, after all. What were they up to down there? Now that's the question. I heard some answers myself, but I don't know if I believe them. And there's a story for another time. Let me see here. Oh, you met old Wally yet? The boy, right. But, not in a mudder way. He just ain't right. Talks to the root, he says. I reckon I know why, too. I ain't never told him this, but I was there at his birth. Poo-hoo! Don't believe me? You wouldn't be the first. But it's true. Why, I was there when he... when he, of course I'm awake. Now, don't believe me. You wouldn't be the first, but it's true. That boy Wally was born under a blood moon. Always strange, they say. Harbinger of changification and whatnot. I heard him cry out his first breath. I did, and I says to myself, that ain't natural. Like the squall of some blackbird. Caw! Oh, don't tell him I said it. He wouldn't believe it anyway. Or maybe he would, come to think of it. You talk to him yet? Boy ain't right. Stop me if I told you this one already. So, I got separated from Crazy Eight, my gang, you see. We've been chased by these big old deadwood, taller than a man with 10 times as many pointy bits. Ooh, nasty fellas. The others, they holed up in this old scrap building and slammed the door. Left me for dead. There was no way in. But there are these old pipes underground. Sewage. Judging by the stink. But I wasn't gonna stay out there with deadwood creeping around. So I held my breath and crawled through what must have been half a mile. I come busting out of the pipes and right into the middle of the Crazy Eight. They were holding me a funeral. I stand up, covered in mud and God knows what else, and just smile at them. And that, friend, is where I got the name Mudtooth. Let me tell you what those folks are up to in that atoll. That Ward 10 and 7, that was where they did their experimenting, see? They made weapons for the Usa. That's what this land was called back then. And the root, you see.
The Usa.
Yes, sir. They found root D and A trapped in red amber, and they just built themselves an army. But this army, it got out of hand and turned against them. Couldn't tell the difference. between the Usanaeans and whatever else there was. Pretty good weapon, if you ask me. Nion slaughtered the whole damn world! Makes you think, though, what else were them Usanaeans capable of? Maybe it's for the best thing around no more. Would you believe old Mudtooth's out of tails? Well, don't, cause it ain't! But I could use some time to simmer before telling the next one. Come back later, yeah? Why, sure, but it ain't right. Well, maybe not that way. Just come back. I'll be seeing you then.
What's this way? Thank you, Boba!
I see you, traveler.
How was the stream? Did you beat the game? Oh my god, my computer is being crazy. Thank you for the follow, Never Ending Well.
You're the one Ford's been waiting for. Well, he doesn't know he's
right. Have a good night, Boba.
She needs help. It's her who needs it. You know. And you don't. Sorry, I shouldn't say. Things get messier when I tell them. I'm Wallace. Did I say that yet? You have a path to take. You choose the first step here, but your path can change if you wanted to.
Oh. Oh, what do I want to be? I kind of want the dog. But I what do I want? What should I pick? I don't know about this game. Hey, Suki. Do you know anything about this game? Because I don't. I kind of want to go hunter, but I want the doggo. Oh, the boba party. I think I'm going to go hunter.
Sent you. They have what you need. They're the next step on your journey. Goodbye, traveler.
Oh, hey, there's a crouch. That's pretty cool. What?
Forgive me. I am not good with Paxotic faces. Oh, it is new. I thought I had seen it before. So difficult to tell Paxotic apart without hoof and horn. I am Saizrak Thadwell. My Paxotic name is Dwell. I sell crystals. Of course, Paxotic.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Need something with a longer barrel.
Well, ain't you a right mutter? Heard that boy what talks in the room? I don't trust Wally with a hot meal. I was only dumb enough to cross him. I don't reckon he was any more specific. Right. Well, the boy's crazy, but he ain't stupid. I can see your gear is, lacking, to say the least. If he asks, tell him I gave you this. No charge.
Ooh!
Away from your problems, but you won't let me run toward something. What are
you're
you so
serious,
goddamn
you?
Afraid of?
So what the hell is this? You're damn right it sounds crazy. But that's how I know you ain't lying.
You've already lost
only Wally
everything.
Would do that to a person. Fine. Well, the only reason anyone bothers me is because I'm good with a hammer. So either I can
you
modify your weapons, or we can
me
find a more creative
you
use for it.
Neville.
Tell you what. I heard you picked up something strange on your little jaunt earlier. Maybe I could do something with it.
Oh.
I don't belong here. I never did. I'm tired of pretending I do.
There. That ought to help with whatever journey he saw you on. Just tell Wally to be more specific next time. Yeah? So we're done here, right? Or do I need the hammer again?
Things will feel better tomorrow.
Hopefully this means you'll be leaving.
What?
Pisses me off when people...
Oh,
I'll make you a deal.
You
find anything interesting out there. Oh, and if you tell anyone I was nice to you...
Haven't I?
Damn.
And what have you done?
Oh, friend. Glad to see you all right.
That's right. But everybody calls me Rage. I can't let
you go. I try to keep folks safe out there.
My specialty is
that's
armor and weapons upgrades. Speaking of which, Beau mentioned
you haven't learned
need some help getting your feet back on
you.
Well, whatever you need, don't be afraid to ask. We all help each other out here. Even McCabe. I don't suppose he was more particular about why. Ha, yeah, that sounds like Bravis. Right. Well, I've got a pretty focused skill set. I reckon I know what he means. Come to me if you ever need to upgrade your equipment.
Oh, I can upgrade?
You know where to find me.
traveler, of course. Wallace said yes.
It does.
Right on time. Sorry I had to see that. But then again, you've been around. I'm sure you know. Families fight. Andrew Ford. Good to make your acquaintance. In the flesh. Oh, I'm as real as a toothache. I'm sure you've got a lot of questions, and I've got a favor to ask. So let's get to it. You first. That's a longer story than I can indulge right now. Let's keep it to this. You know how some things you drink can make you drunk, and some things you eat can make you sick or sleepy? Well, other things do this. Huh. Not my way. And you want to be careful what you wish for, Trav.
Yeah, if you start playing it, let me know and we can play together.
Not you precisely, as in name, rank, serial number. But I knew someone was coming. Aren't you clever? Skeptic. That's fine. It so happens I knew you'd be coming today. Or I hope. Our young Wallace told me. Wallace? He's a special kid. A lot like somebody I used to know. She had bad dreams, too. Dreams about things that hadn't yet come to pass. It's more like you can see really far into the present sometimes. Oh, nothing too dangerous. I've got to marshal my reach. Let me see if I can get you up to speed.
Aw, there's some cute emotes.
Arguing's not the same as fighting. Clem and I have known each other longer than anyone else here. That's a lot of water to put under a narrow bridge. Looks can be deceiving. In fact, she's 132.
What?
She was 16 when I first met her, over a lifetime ago. But she hasn't aged a day since. You see, Clementine, she's forever young. Height of hormones, height of feeling, height of hurting. I'm sure you remember yourself. Or if not, that little scrapper you came in with brought it all back to you. Compared to who? Bo might be young, but he knows the run of a ward. Learned from the best. He was orphaned, just a kid. Ward 13, sort of adopted him. Ran security when he got old enough. Did a damn good job of it. Only made sense to put him in charge once we started up here. Don't think there's a soul in town has lost as much as Riggs. Don't know how that man gets up out of bed every day. Huh. Want some intel, huh? Here now, traveler. You look like someone preparing for a journey. I won't lie. That's exactly the kind of scrapper I need. I've got some business to take care of down in the old ward. And I was hoping you'd be up for helping.
Oh.
Get some weaponry. Then meet me down by the ward gate. And we'll talk more.
Thank you.
we head out? Or, is there something you wanted to do first?
Right. Let's see what dangers still lurk in the old ward.
Okay. We're in a new area. The old ward.
This used to be a research facility, cutting edge. We did things down here nobody dreamed of. Not before nor since.
Yet, for all our manpower, we didn't know what the stones really were. Until it was too late.
The stones?
The world stones. Giant red crystals that let us see into other worlds. Even travel to them. So, what? We just hide the stones away and hope the Soviets hadn't found their own? No, we had to know everything there was to know about them. It was a matter of national security, of pride. So, yeah, we opened the door and walked through.
But something was waiting on the other side.
It didn't happen right away. The inhabitants of the worlds we traveled to couldn't follow us. We thought we were safe. But yeah, the route found a way. After that, well, we all know what happened after that. Locked, huh? Well, this is my house. Come on. I gave Ellen a few things to hang on to in case of emergency. She must have hidden it around here somewhere.
Come on, Ellie, where'd you hide it?
Ooh.
That red thing. We call it a dragon. Don't ask why. Take it with you. You might need it.
Let me explore, man.
There you are. Hurry up.
Hey, take a look at that matchbook you found. I got a hunch. Let's get this door unlocked. Can't stand around all day.
Okay.
Is that the...
The World Stone. Yes. Or part of it, anyway. Every shard's as useful as the whole. We shut it down after Harsgard died. Like I told Ellen at the time. The damn thing's more dangerous. Of course not. Never mind. Now, let's see if that worked.
Worked to do what exactly?
Oh!
I wonder if the Andrew Ford
What?
Go back. Tell Bo to bury this place. Not just lock it away, but get some explosives and bury it in a tomb of concrete. More dangerous than useful, traveler. Remember that.
Ford. Ford? Ford!
Oh, man. Bo is gonna be pissed.
Damn, is she dead? Touch the crystal. Ooh, blood root. Beatific Palace. Okay.
Clementine! Ford?
Shit! Where are you guys?
Oh, this is all insane! With the crystal and Ford!
Better get moving if I'm gonna find Clementine.
Whoa, whoa. Okay, we're in our first actual dungeon.
Here they come.
Is that all of them? Ooh, that's something. Dead. I can't do that. Oh, dang. Yeah, I need to use the shotgun. Okay, this game is hard. Oh my god, I'm getting ganked now. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, what is this? Alright, Luminite Crystal. Ooh. I guess I'll read this. One day the forest king announced an enormous feast and invited every animal in the forest. And one of you will be my, receive my boon, the invitation said, but whoever displeases me will receive a bow, which means a noose for every animal knew of the king's capricious and cruelty. Soon all the animals came. The Jubhawk put on his finest clothes, preening his feathers and polishing his horns. The Hound fluffed its scales and licked its eyes, cleaner than it had ever been. The Nara shed a new skin and combined all its tails. Every animal presented their very best. All except the Dropper, whose coat dripped with cave slime and smelled of wild fungus. What are you doing? The Jubhawk snapped. Why are you not rooting for the king? Droopy yawned. Your posture looks so unpleasant. Everyone is stiff and miserable. You should have at least bathed, said the Jubhawk. The king notices you. You will surely hang. The Dropper shrugged. At least I am comfortable. The feast was served, though the king had not yet arrived. The animals praised their spread throughout, though they ate little for the fear of appearing gluttonous. The Jupiter, however, appreciated none of it, tearing it into his food like one of the half-starved. You fool. The feast is for show, hissed the Jupiter. The king is surely watching. Then I may die, the Jupiter said. Crumbs from a large piece of apple cake spilled from his mouth. But I will not die empty. Afterwards, with the loud fanfare, the king arrived and took his place at the head of the table. The animals rose and bowed, all except the Jupiter, who was so full he could not stand. While the others stood in front of him, blocking his view, he scratched his belly and let loose a roaring belch. All in attendance gasped in horror, but the crowd was so great that the king could not see who was at fault. Who was that? Bellowed the king, tell me and you may yet live. But the animals were afraid of drawing attention to themselves, and so no one moved. But the Jubhawk feared staying quiet even more. And so, though it betrayed his friend, he raised one winged claw and pointed at the now sleeping Dropper. It was him, your majesty. The Dropper dishonored your otherwise divine feast. The Dropper snored like a wood beetle. His fur was caked with drink and apple crumbs. The kingdom barked his name. Awake and speak for yourself. Sorry. Gotta hang now. The Drooper stayed awake. He looked around and saw all eyes on him, most notably the forest kings he swallowed. It was a good feast, he said. I enjoyed it very much, though I may never eat again. Silence boomed throughout the feasting hall. Everyone watched the king, both excited and terrified by what he might do. Without warning, the king's head flew back and he roared in laughter. The other animals remained silent, paralyzed in fear. The foolish Dropper grinned sleepily. When the king stopped laughing, he said, "You will eat again, Dropper. This and much more, for more than any other. You have enjoyed the feast I laid out before, and you shall receive my boon." And the king ordered the food be brought to the Dropper's cave every day, enough to keep him fat and fed for the rest of his days. The king pointed at the Jubhawk, "But you betrayed your friend for a boon. You are more treacherous and selfish than any of my subjects, and so your next shall receive a bow." And he ordered him arrested. That evening, the Jubhawk was hanged, though by the time of the execution, the king had forgotten his crime and none was posted. The Jubhawk died for nothing, but the Dripper was and still is happy to this day. More posture for no one, boons and bows be damned. Why do I keep on getting achievements? Is Twitch breaking again? Oh, another book. In the birth of the Fae, in the beginning of times, the Fae did suffer from a terrible disease known as wasting. None were safe, for the wasting struck both young and old, rich and poor, and had neither cure nor remedy. This was a story of how the wasting was conquered. Day and night, they prayed for the Creator with their tears and blood. Hear us, O great Spirit of Light, and show us what we have done. We no longer drink blood, nor kill in revelry. These laws and morals we upheld. Tell us our sin, O God, and we will repent. Yet for all their fervor, the Great Spirit did not answer them. We must seek him out, said one of the warriors named Armin. How, the people asked. The Great Spirit dwells beyond the sun, where no Fae has ever gone. No Fae but ourselves, said Armin's brother, the hunter known as Aramor. And who better? Armin agreed. We must, for if the Spirit would never hear us, every Fae shall perish. So the two brothers set out to find the home of the Great Spirit, taking them with them the Tola the Dreamer and Sariel the Seer. Together, these four undertook the long, impossible journey to the temple beyond the sun. In the weeks that followed, Sariel guided them down the Queen's byway to the wild, and from there the forbidden peaks, where not even Aramor could find sustenance for themselves. The suns blazed upon their heads. Their legs became like chests packed with sodden clothes, and hunger tore at them from inside. On the 17th day, Tola fell to the ground with a sharp cry. Aramor ran to her, but she did not respond to his pleas. Her face bore the first outlines of scales, a sign of wasting. Sariel wailed in anguish. The Great Spirit has abandoned us. We are nothing to him. Aramor rebuked her. No, our saint creator would not discard us. This is but a test of our faith. We are close, said Aramor. We only need to reach the peak of that mountain. Then we will find the Great Spirit and end this curse for Tola and all of us. Sariel nodded, though tears dripped from her eyes, for the mountain was tall and the days were long. Tola regained consciousness, but her scales became more pronounced. Soon she could no longer bear her own weight, and Aramor had to carry her. The scales appeared on Armin's face as well. It's useless, said Sarah. When I am halfway to the summit, the Great Spirit cares nothing for us. Silence. Armin drew his knife and slashed his ear. You will not blaspheme the Creator again. Armin grabbed Armor's waist, though his grip was weak and his hand trembled. Peace, brother. Do not stain your hand for the one who grieves. Above all others, we who undertake this journey must not sin. This is a test. Her heresy undermines us, brother. The Creator would relish her death. We do not kill, Armin sat down and then drained from the forest behind his own word. We must carry on, whatever the cost. For days more, they climbed until Aramor had his brother and Tola slipped in our consciousness. Starvation clawed at their stomachs, but the summit was near, drawing them onward. They reached the peak. The suns blared out their faces, and the wind breathed cold on their necks. Yet the peak was barren. There was no temple, only a sea of mountains beyond, each taller than the last. Armin dropped to his knees in despair. Armin fell from his back to the ground. Sariel, who had not yet seen, scaled the peak behind them and cried in anguish. Tola, no. The brothers turned. Sariel buried her face in Tola's chest. Tola's skin had turned into ashen white. Her cheeks fell. Her eyes lay open, staring out into the vast mountain range, yet seeing none of it. Tola was dead. Sariel lifted her face to the sky and cried, why? What good is any of this? Great Spirit has disowned us. We are nothing to him. Damn you, seer, said Armin through the tears of anguish and dampened his face. Silence, you blasphemy, or I will silence for you. The Great Spirit does not exist, she spat. Or else he is useless, being unworthy of worship. Your Great Spirit has brought nothing but anguish. Aramir gripped at the dagger at his belt, his knuckles whitening about the hilt. You live only because my brother spoke for you. Our anguish is caused by you. No, you caused this. We should have never come. If it weren't for your foolish plan, Tola yet may yet live. She pulled the blame from her sister's sheath and stood on her feet. Her chest heaving with every fiery breath. No more will die for your dogma. Sariel leapt atop Aramor. The hunter tried to pull out his knife in defense, but it was caught in the scabbard. He glared defiantly as the seer brought her blade down onto his neck. Oh yeah, I should tell him I'm alive. Suddenly, she cut short, releasing the strangled cough from her lips. Blood dripped from her chin, and Arma saw that Armin Arma saw the armor beneath her, two hands on the hilt of his own blade sunk deep into her chest. Arma stood up with a sudden strength and shoved her back. The blade slipped from her body and she fell to the ground by her sister. Her blood crystallizing in the cold mountain air. Brother, Arma, you breathe your skin. Armin looked at his arms and he was touched his face. The scales had fallen and his strength returned. The wasting had left him, but I sinned. I killed for you, yet murderous. You murdered a heretic, Brother Armor. It's a sign. Armin stood up a while longer, rubbing his hands up and down his arms into memes, and finally nodded. So the Great Spirit is on our side. Let us press on. It was still many days before they reached their destination. The wasting returned to both this time. As the time passed, their strength fled. Their weapons and packs became too heavy for them and were left behind. They could no longer lift their arms, and their lungs felt as though they were they've breathed sand. Finally, they crested the tallest summit and saw a silhouette in the light of the suns, the temple that they had sought for so long. With a small, fresh store of strength, they pushed through the doors and stepped inside. Glorious being towered above them, radiating beauty and light. Instinctively, the brothers fell on their knees. Armin was the first to find his voice. Oh, great spirit, we've come to beseech you for thine help for our people. The being gazed upon them, but said nothing. The brother glanced at each other. Armin said, we have undertaken a long and hard journey to save the Fae. They are beset by the disease, the wasting, which we may ourselves die from. Now, we have kept all your laws, Armin said, yet the wasting remains. Please tell us what we must do so that we repent. The Great Spirit did not move. It stared at them for what seemed like an eternity. The brothers, pressing their faces on the temple floor, we have come so far, said Armor. We need you, Great Creator. We are nothing without you. Again, silence stretched until the brothers wondered the spirit could, if the until the brothers wondered the spirit could even hear them. Finally, though it did not open its mouth, the Great Spirit's voice boomed throughout the temple. I did not create you. Arma and Arma glanced at each other in confusion. Sure you did, said Arma. Thou art the Great Spirit, the God of Alfe. I am your Great Spirit, I said. And I truly do rule over Alfe, but I did not create you. The Creator gave its creatures free will. Wasted and squandered, for the Fae are wicked people of chaos and destruction. I have tried to continue offering you guidance, laws, and teachings. All of it betrayed. The Fae love only death, and I can only try to contain your ruination. No seekers. I will not save you from that which saves the world. The brothers gasped in silence until Armor said, the wasting. It came from you. The Great Spirit said nothing but turned away from them. The light of the temple dimmed as it did so. It came from you, with the shout. Armor stood and leaped at the Great Spirit. Armin did the same. The brothers grappled their god, clawing at its eyes, sinking into their teeth and flesh. The spirit howled and tore at them, calling upon the rage of storms. The great doors of the temple crashed open. Gale force-like winds whipped around them, slicing in their skins with the breeze. Lightning shook the very walls until the floor itself cracked. Yet the brothers battered and trashed there. Ersatz created until finally, with that cry that shook the sky, the great spirit fell to the ground. Its blood filled the temple and the light faded from its eyes. Arm in arm, lay next to it, breathing heavily, the scales from their skin and their wounds healed. The wasting left them, lest every fae in that moment never turn again. Brother, said Armor, what have we done? Armor pushed himself from his feet of the master body. We saved ourselves, but the Great Spirit, we have killed our god. Not a god, brother. He never was. Armor turned and looked through the temple doors to the world beyond. There is no good god but ourselves. Okay. Interesting stories. Ooh. Okay. We got some scrap. Whoa, where? Fuck did you come from, sir?
Here they come.
Oh god, I was trying to dodge away. Oh, there was a shortcut that I missed. Damn it! Okay. I didn't even see what was down here. Oh, we got a chest. Consumable duration. Is that the thing? No.
do this.
What am I doing? Okay.
Oh.
Ah, damn it. There we go. We're slowly making our way through this. Okay. Alright, we got handgun ammo again. There we go.
Looking good.
Yeah! Get out of here, nerd! I hear something. Okay, we're running out of ammo for the handgun. Question mark? Question mark?
Real pretty. Yeah, I don't trust this place.
Interesting.
Here we go.
I'll take that. Oh, this is the start. Isn't it? Yeah, it's the start. And where does this take me? This takes me to Ironboro. Oh, that's how I do melee.
Not right about this place.
Where are you shooting me from, man? Thank you, Joey. Thank you, he's dead. Why is this... What? That's weird. Give me 1 second. I might need to change Nightbot. Nightbot might just be Bully. Protection. Disable that. All right, there we go. Sorry, I think it might have had the permissions a little weird. I just recently integrated Nightbot. I'm sorry. Yeah, Nightbot isn't just being a bully. But how was the stream, Joey? Thank you so much for the raid, man. I appreciate it. Are we at 100 now? Oh my god, thank you, who all followed? Thank you, Raven, thank you, Evil, you helped us reach our follower goal of 100. Woo! Get away from me! Oh, I was pressing the wrong button. Okay, I don't think I'm ready for this area yet. Oh, hey, Crimson. What you doing here? Where'd you coming from? This is scary. Can I not do that? Oh, that's not that. I have no idea what I'm doing. I am lost. Joey, hold me. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm scared. Oh, hey, Suki, you're back. Time to go for a shootout. I died for fire. Oh, hey, Fancy. This is what happens when you give a fox a gun. He doesn't know what he's doing. Get out of here. Hey, There we go, we got him. I saw the path. Damn it. Let's read a book. Oh, nice. The Truth of the Ceruleans. We arrived at the Cerulean Mountains community on the 13th day of the on the Turn of Deaths. Corpses decorated the cliffside roads, some no older than a few days, and the smell of feces. I don't want to read that all. Get wrecked, noob! Woo! No more scary stuff? No more scary. It is 120 for me. I don't like the sound of that name. Here we go. I saw a wall I could scroll on. On that door. I don't like this map. It's confusing. Did you just wake up, Crimson? What just happened there? Magic pen. But I think there's one more. Area I can go to. Nimue's retreat. Skulls for the Skull Throne. Where the fuck am I going? Oh no. This way, here we go. So then I started blasting. Get over here. I think there was one over here. Oh no, there's not. I think I might need to travel to Row 13. I didn't shout out Joey, did I? And then I also forgot about Bulma. She did raid earlier. Yeah, I think I returned to Ward 13.
Start at the beginning. You were with the Founder in the old ward, right? Where'd he go? Knew the Founder was up to something. I mean, who else wants to visit the old ward, huh? Look, I'm sorry you got involved in this, Traveler. So, then what happened? Wait, what? Clementine? Where is she? Is she all right? Right, sorry. Clementine, she means a lot.
What's up?
We gotta find her. I'll get everybody together. If she went through the world stones, yeah, damn straight you could. She could be anywhere, like worlds away. Alright, I'll get Bravis.
Aw, Joey with the left.
Oh, what the hell am I doing? I don't know what's out there any more than you do. I'd be putting the whole town at risk. Clem wouldn't want that. Hell, it's a miracle you came back. Oh, I'm sorry. Town will help you all it can, but thanks, Traveler.
Yeah, this is the game I was talking about, though, Joey. This is Remnant 2.
Any supplies you need. You know, Ford used to tell me, old Commander Ford, not the Founder, that a leader and a hero are two different things. A leader's place is always with her people. I thought she was just taking a dig at her family, leaving all the time. I think I'm starting to understand her better now. You need anything?
Whoa, that's not the world crystal I came from. I chose the hunter class, but you can pick a class where you have a dog friend. Don't want to upgrade a weapon. There are some rings I can get, I think, with how much money I have.
Hey there, friend. You might.
I kind of just fell into Shaggy. In my old gang, no one else wanted to do it.
Okay. I'm coming, girly. You want me to come over here? I got you. Go to Namea the Butterba. Namea's retreat. I get the feeling I'm running toward the boss. This screams boss or something. I'm scared. Whoa! Hello.
Of the Fae, and
and counselor to the one true king. Or so I was. Still, it is my gift to see what cannot be seen, and to forge what cannot be forged. So then, strange one, what brings you thus before me?
Oh.
Like you, you say? You are a unique taste, strange one, unknown to me. But your form, perhaps? Yes, it is familiar. I may have seen this Clementine in dreams and visions. She wears your shape, yes. But she tastes different. Powerful. I have seen her in a kingdom of great authority, filled with doors and possibilities. But I do not recognize it, nor can I find the way. Not here, not as things are. Oh, the kingdom is in disarray, strange one. The one true king has been deposed. But the manner of his deposition has wrought unforeseen consequences for everyone. Now, an imposter sits upon the throne, a deceiver and a fraud. They must be slain if I am to fix what is broken, and perhaps if you are to find what you seek. I cannot ask this of you, but were you to accept this burden, to slay the deceiver, you would find them in the floors above, beyond an opulent door carved of their...
Ooh, boss time.
And if I can provide you with wisdom or a Namue's artisanship, is your... The imposter yet lives, strange one.
I don't know what I need to do to kill the imposter. Are you gonna tell me?
Gracing me with your breath. As do so. Oh, a place of great beauty. Palaces of gold, fields of green and blue.
Fuchsia.
Cheerful glades lit with the sun. You have not seen the light, strange one. One can see hints of it here and there, intertwined with the dreary sphere that has since festered around us. I will find a way to restore it. Indeed, the seed of a plan has already been set in motion. Yet, to voice it would raise my hopes too far, or worse. The one true king rules this kingdom with an iron fist.
Be right back, I'm getting me some water.
With promises of freedom and prosperity. And to be sure, there was prosperity. For some. Those who did not offer praise and fealty, who did not share in the royal values, who were deemed unworthy in myriad ways, their prosperity was taken and given to the favored. It was freedom for some at a cost to many. And eventually, there were some who sought to plot against him. And so, the tyrant was deposed. But at a cost. None, not even I.
Air and back water required.
To advance him at
Thank you, Joey. Have a good night, man. Again, I appreciate the raid, friend. I think I'm supposed to go up now and I can do the imposter queen king thing? I don't know. The sad part is most worlds are apparently different, so I don't know what I'm doing.
Here they come.
Who? Who is they? This is the only thing that I can do. Oh, there's another face. Oh, I didn't even put on the ring yet to do more damage. Oops. Oh, it auto-equipped. I don't know why that was so funny. Ow, 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 ow. Okay. That seems to be a good portion of this area cleared. Okay. Be on the lookout for enemies that'll jump from nowhere and just ambush me. Can't go that way. Anybody else? No? Okay. I'm out of dragon hearts. Mama, I am gonna die. What the? Child? Child? They freaking ganked me. Did I just moan? Okay. Okay, I think that's everyone. Okay. fuck did they come from? No, seriously, where the fuck did they come from? Oh, you gotta be kidding me! She freaking got me by a by my left butt cheek.
No, great, more bad news.
Anyone else? Thank you. Alright, handgun ammo up. Alright, there shouldn't be any more big guys, right? No! God, I was trying to switch to concussive and I didn't. Okay. Okay.
Look alive.
Okay. That seems like everyone. Okay, we haven't used any heals yet.
Thank you.
I knew you were coming, sir. Thank you. Handgun ammo's running fairly low.
That's it. For now.
Okay. Okay. Do you? Where are you? I don't even see a person. Thank you.
At least that's over.
Okay. Oh my god, I can take damage from heights. Nice. We got a treasure. And there's nothing over here left, so let's go this way. Slowly making progress. Okay.
Here,